Good morning. Today we are going to review integrals in kinematics as a part of the AP Physics C mechanics curriculum.
Flippin' physics!
The equation for instantaneous acceleration is acceleration equals the derivative of velocity with respect to time. And remember, every derivative can be rearranged to make an integral or an antiderivative, and we can do that like this. We multiply both sides by dv and then take the definite integral of both sides. Definite integral just means the limits are defined. For example, on the left-hand side, when we take the integral with respect to velocity, the limits are from velocity initial to velocity final. And on the right-hand side, when we take the integral with respect to time, the limits are from time initial to time final. The integral of dv is just velocity from velocity initial to velocity final, which equals velocity final minus velocity initial, which equals the change in velocity. In other words, change in velocity equals the definite integral of acceleration with respect to time. Billy, the derivative represents the slope of a function. What does the integral or the antiderivative represent?
The integral is the area under the curve, and the area under the curve specifically means the area between the curve and the horizontal axis, where the area above the horizontal axis is positive and the area below the horizontal axis is negative.
Correct. So the area between the acceleration curve and the time axis is the change in velocity of the object. And now we can do the same thing we just did with acceleration with velocity. Starting with velocity equals the derivative of position as a function of time, we can arrive at the fact that displacement equals the definite integral of velocity with respect to time. And that's highly redundant with what we did with acceleration, so I'm not going to walk my way all the way through that. Okay, let's move on to graphs of position, velocity, and acceleration as a function of time. Velocity is the derivative of position with respect to time. Therefore, the slope of a position as a function of time graph is velocity. Acceleration is the derivative of velocity with respect to time. Therefore, the slope of a velocity as a function of time graph is acceleration. The definite integral of acceleration with respect to time is change in velocity. Therefore, the area under an acceleration as a function of time graph is change in velocity. The definite integral of velocity with respect to time is change in position or displacement. Therefore, the area under a velocity as a function of time graph is displacement.
Mr. P, what are these graphs for?
I don't know. What motion do y'all think these graphs represent?
It looks like the acceleration is constant at just less than 10 meters per second squared. So this is an object in free fall.
And the initial velocity is positive, and the final velocity is negative, and in the middle, the velocity is zero.
So these graphs represent the motion of an object in free fall, which was initially thrown upward.
Yes, that is correct. If we assume the acceleration of an object is constant as a function of time, we can use the definition of instantaneous acceleration and indefinite integrals to derive two of the uniformly accelerated motion equations. We can rearrange the equation for instantaneous acceleration to get dv equals acceleration dt, and then we can take the indefinite integral of both sides. The indefinite integral of just dv is the velocity as a function of time. And the indefinite integral of acceleration with respect to time is acceleration times time plus a constant c. In order to solve for the constant c, we can substitute an initial value of zero in for time. In other words, the velocity initial, the velocity at time t equals zero, is equal to the acceleration times zero plus the constant c. In other words, that constant c is equal to the velocity initial. Substituting in the velocity initial for the constant c gives us one of our uniformly accelerated motion equations. Velocity final, or the velocity as a function of time, equals the velocity initial plus acceleration times time. Bo, could you please do what we just did with the equation for instantaneous velocity?
We know instantaneous velocity is the derivative of position with respect to time. multiply by dt to get dx equals v dt, integrate both sides to get the integral of dx equals the integral of velocity with respect to time. The integral of dx is just x as a function of time, but I don't know what to do with the integral of velocity with respect to time. In uniformly accelerated motion, the acceleration is constant, but the velocity changes with respect to time, so I don't know what to do with that.
We just derived the equation for velocity as a function of time in uniformly accelerated motion, so...
Oh, yeah, so we can substitute in for velocity the equation velocity initial plus acceleration times time. The integral of that with respect to time is velocity times time plus 1/2 times acceleration times time squared plus a constant c.
And you can find the constant by letting time equal zero.
Yeah. Use the initial condition of time equals zero so that the position at time t equals zero, which equals velocity times zero plus 1/2 times zero squared plus c. That shows the initial position is the constant c, and therefore the position as a function of time equals the position initial plus velocity initial times time plus 1/2 times acceleration times time squared, which is one of the uniformly accelerated motion equations.
Very nice. That completes my review of integrals in kinematics. Next, feel free to enjoy my momentum and impulse review for AP Physics C Mechanics, or you can visit my AP Physics C Review webpage. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.